Hi everyone! Few months back I found a CNC aluminum version of Voron Tap made by Chaoticlab, and here's my review. I bought it for around 50 euro from AliExpress. This is the version 2 CNC Tap. It has few advantages over the first Chaoticlab version. The most important one is the use of photo micro sensor from Umron, which can be powered with 5 to 24 volts. The version 1 had a 24 volts optic micro switch. At just 65 grams, it feels sturdy and well built. The do-it-yourself Voron Tap relies on MGN09 carriage, while the CNC Tap has a smaller MGN07 linear rail from Highwind. It is more compact and it could be mounted without disassembly. So here you see the contents of the box. All needed components are supplied. There are screws, bracket for installing a limit switch, cable with connectors for direct connection to the tool head PCB, or if you don't use a PCB, you can replace the JST connector with a microfit, or connect wire to wire with the incoming wires from your control board. There is no installation manual in the box, however, Chaoticlab provides a PDF step-by-step guide on their GitHub. It is very detailed Voron style document, well illustrated, and the installation is pretty easy. The only other documentation you'll need is on Voron GitHub, and it's a list of changes to apply to the printer configuration file in Clipper in order to run Voron Tap. Before installing the CNC Tap on your printer, you have to screw the limit switch bracket. If your limit switch is on connector, you can install it on the bracket at this stage. If using a Hall effect sensor and stops like me, there is a printable magnet holder that attaches to the limit switch bracket. It can be downloaded from Chaoticlab GitHub. Installing the tap on the MGN12 X-rail is as easy as the installation of the stock carriage, because the CNC tap comes fully assembled and it doesn't require to take it apart. The most tricky part is to re-tighten your belts with equal tension, which is essential for the printing quality. Once installed, the printhead slides smoothly. The magnetic assembly and the Highwind linear rail give perfect stability to the assembly. I couldn't detect any perceivable Y-axis play, though I forced quite a bit the printhead. To finish the setup, you have to change few things in your printer configuration file in Clipper. These changes are described on Voron GitHub. I found the Z offset with the probe calibrate tool in Clipper, and then with manual probing with piece of paper. So for me it's a slightly negative value of minus 0.08 mm. I had to change a bit my print style G code. So here first it gets the temperature for the first layer for the hot bed and the hot end. Then it homes, it heats up the bed, it probes with coat nozzle, and then it performs the Z tilt adjust and it starts printing. With this sequence, the only preparation I have to do is to clean the nozzle from any remaining extrusion from a previous print, because otherwise it will not probe correctly. Here you see the complete print start sequence. You may wonder what's the resonance profile with CNC Tap. I'm not equipped to measure it, however, I'm not using crazy accelerations, so what I can say is I'm getting the same print quality as before. That's all from me. Thanks for watching and see you for my next video. Bye bye.